SoundsAndGear.com, taking a look at Absynth 5. This is the interface you get when you first open it up. As you can see, it's pretty much like the core browser. They use core sounds by default, the core sound format. So these load up in the core, and any Absynth sounds, like core expansions that you buy for the core library, show up in Absynth. That's what these blue ones are. They have one of those expansions. So you basically got your instruments. Then you know, the more characteristics you pick, the fewer, you know, selections you'll get. So to be closer to exactly what you're looking for. Then the rest of it, you up here, you got your performance controls. You can set up all your different MIDI controllers and assignments and all that. You can change this. Here's where you can mess with the waveforms of the sounds that you're playing with. There's your envelope. Here's your LFOs. You got three LFOs in here. Here's your effects, different types of effects, routing and all that. And then here's your patch, where you got your three oscillators, your filter section, your mod section, and then your master effects and stuff like that. For me, the best part of Absynth 5, and the reason why I wanted to check it out, is this down here. The sound mutation makes it easy to create your own sounds. Basically, this is how you come up with brand new sounds right here. You got your random amount and your mutation amount. Basically, what it means is you mutate it, and it'll change a bunch of settings randomly based on how you choose it and how much you want to mutate. You can have it do just one. Like if you deselect these, it'll just mutate that stuff, or you can have it mutate everything. It just depends on what you want to do. Down here, you can do your fine tuning. So that's the main thing for me, is being able to easily get in and make your own sounds. But also, I like the preset sounds, because Absynth has a sound that many other synths don't have. It's different. Like, take for instance this piano right here. And that's just, you know, it's got this real ambient, it can do this real ambient involving type stuff, which I really like. I mean, you can do some general synth stuff, but I mean, I have a lot of synths that can do general stuff. I know Absynth can do stuff that other synths can't, and makes it easy. Say you wanted to do an organ that was digital, monophonic for rock, you know, pop, you know, jazz, you know, house. Well, see, you only got four of them, so I'm not sure what genre they fall in, but like when I first opened up this and installed it, was just the first thing I do when I get a new synth is go through, you know, if I'm going to review it and just start checking out the sounds. And I couldn't get through all the sounds, because every time I would come across something like it, it made me want to go actually try to put it into some music or something. So that's always a good thing. And like I said, you can come down here and mess with the different fine tunings and everything. Mess with the resonance if you want to. Brightness. So it just depends on what you want to do. I really like the pads in here. Really, really like the pads. Pads are amazing. A lot of evolving textures you got going on, which is dope to me. So if you like me and you like to create your own sounds, get into some sound design, Absynth is amazing for that. Because it makes it easy to. Make your own stuff. Say, I want to mutate that. See what we come up with. Say, I didn't like that. I can retry it. That one's a little too slow for me. So, say, I want to retry it again. No, maybe I didn't like that one. That was pretty cool. So you can go in here. You can go in here and compare. And then the one you just made. So if you want to save it, you can save your patch. If you don't, you can just clear the history. So it's very easy to get in there and make your own stuff. Like I said, you can pick. You can just mutate specific parts. You can check how much randomization you want to happen. Stuff like that. So it's very easy to make your own sound, and the sound is nothing sounds like an absinthe that I've played with. So even if you don't want to get in and make your own sounds, the sounds that they already have in there are you know, top notch. A lot of your stuff has already, you know, gotten modulation. I mean, it's very, like I said, it's the textures, they move. All the sounds are, they move a lot. So, you definitely got some crazy guitars in there. You can get some. Definitely get some nice textures going on. I mean, you got a little pluck strings going on. A little something Asia. And I think you can, I'm pretty sure you can bring like your own samples in here to use as like, to start making your own sounds. Like, you know, to use as a basis for your own sounds or whatever. Like I said, I haven't gone too deep into it. The main draw for me was being able to get in and make sounds quickly, or you know, having a different sound than all the other synths that I have and have played with. Granular. We got some brass stuff going on. And I definitely can't go through everything that's in here. You wanna get your movie score on. I mean, this is just some crazy stuff, man. So even if you're not making your own sounds, the stuff that's already in here is you know, just crazy. Yeah, man, so nothing really sounds like absinthe. I really like I said, I like it for its different sound, especially like the pads and the evolving textures that you can get out of it. Like I said, I got instruments that got leads and all that stuff, but absinthe has something that a lot of those don't. And that's what I like about it. Plus, it makes it easy for you to get in and create your own stuff, which is always like a synth that makes it easy. So, yeah.